She wants me to crash for her birthday?
Win, not crash.
Oh my goodness.
Throughout this season, the conditions of all of our races have varied from being wet to too dry to just completely blown out, loose. But this race had absolutely perfect conditions. And this race was Whitefish, Montana. We left at around 2 o'clock on Friday because I had just left Prodigy Camp.
Which, by the way, was amazing.
So when we arrived, we hooked up with all of our friends that were racing with us. So actually, the day before, Connor crashed on the man-made rock garden on our course, and he ripped up his arm, had to get, I think it was like 13 stitches or something, so he was out for the weekend. So I gave him my camera and he got some shots from me. Thank you so much, Connor, for doing that. That was awesome. The next morning, we woke up, we went and got our tickets, and we started riding. Before I started practicing on my course, I took a lap with Evan, who we brought to the race, on the Cat 3 course.
Oh, ah, last year. I love downhill bikes.
After the warm-up lap, I started practicing on my course. Olin took me down the course because he had been there a day before us. And he just kind of showed me all the main features on the course, and we compared lines.
Nice.
Later on Saturday, Colin broke his thumb. Our friend group was kind of dropping like flies. Connor was out with stitches, Colin had just broken a bone, and it was actually on the same corner that a lot of other people had crashed on. Evan and I went back to the van. And let me say, Whitefish never ceases to entertain you in the parking lot. So when we got back, there was a fire dancer in the parking lot, like swinging these like, They must have been like cloths on chains dipped in gasoline or something. I don't know the physics or whatever of it. But yeah, so we got to watch some fire dancing. And then one of the teams, I think it was the West Coast team, they, on the side of their tent, were projecting a really old mountain biking movie. So we got to watch that. And then after that, we just went to bed. I may be blue, but I wish you could see the wicked truth. Now, I forgot to mention, both of the other two people in the top three, Henry and Talon, were gone. So the pressure was really on because I really wanted to lock down the first place for this race. We got up Sunday morning and we worked on our bikes, ate breakfast, and we went up for our practice laps.
I really like this weekend's course. I feel like it's a lot different from a lot of the other courses that we've had because it's more of a feature trail than just a straight downhill course. Like, you have time to rest in between each rock garden or feature. So I don't know, it's different. I like it. I don't know if I like it as much as I did Tamarack's course, but I think it's up there.
If I could change the course, I definitely have no uphills. And let's see here, what else? There's some weird tabletops that just you lose your speed on. And yeah.
13 stitches in my elbow. An almost fractured hand. It's not good. I can't grab my bars, can't do much, so I'm just stuck being the camera guy, which, I mean, I can't complain, but it's whatever.
We got up to the top of the race course early. I wanted to just have some time to clear my head. I listened to some music before my race run, and they postponed the race for, I think, like an hour. I didn't know why. But when the pros started dropping, it started raining, which did not mean good things for the race run. So my dad texted me. He said, somebody crashed on the main feature. Be careful, the rock is slick. So that put me on edge for the race run. I listened to some music, closed my eyes, just calmed down a little bit. And right before the race run, the sun came out. I was the first person to drop in my age group. So I just, you know, took a few breaths and dropped.
And that is your Cat 2 men, 15 to 18.